So welcome back, students. So today we are going to study about another measuring instrument for vibration, and that is called as frequency measuring instrument. So it's frequency measuring instruments. So basically we are going to study three different instruments. So first one is like a single reed frequency meter, or its another name is Fullerton tachometer. So this is the construction of that particular instrument. Okay. Basically, there is a strip, this particular strip, and a known mass M is attached on this particular strip. There is a screw mechanism out over here, which is holding this particular strip. We can move this strip in this particular lateral directions, so that this L can be changed. So once you have this particular length L, you can know what would be the frequency of a particular instrument or a particular sample, component, machine, whatever you are going to see. So let's see how it works and how about the construction. So first of all, there is a bracket. Okay. This is the bracket. On this bracket, you have a slide. In this slide, okay, you keep this strip, this particular strip out over here, and there is a screw out over here. So this screw you can adjust, and you can move this strip up and down. So this is the side view, so you can see, like, you can move it out in this particular direction. This particular strip at the end, okay, we are keeping it in the machine. So if I want to measure the vibrations of the machine and to know its frequency, what I do is, like, I place the end of the strip on this particular machine. Now what happens is, like, this machine is going to vibrate out. So this particular string or the strip is going to vibrate, and it is going to have, like, up and down motion out over here. Now when the motion is being transmitted to this strip, there will be certain motion happening on this entire strip, on this particular bar also. Now what happens is, like, I move this screw, I change the length of this particular string, moving, like, near and far. As I move it about this particular lateral direction, what happens is, like, at a particular moment, this mass or this strip will be having maximum amplitude vibrations. So we know, like, when it happens to give maximum amplitude of vibrations, that means it is in resonance. Okay, and when does the resonating condition happen? Is the excitation frequency, the excitation frequency is equal to natural frequency. So what we do is, like, we find the natural frequency of this particular strip with respect to this one. Now you see, like, there is a mass, there is a length. So if you can remember, we can find delta. Delta is equal to WL cube upon 3A. This is the deformation happening in this strip when we have a mass attached at the end. K is equal to W upon delta. So if you know, like, this one, L cube by 3EI would be your stiffness, and omega is under root of K by M. So if you look at this one, it would be, you will be getting this particular, it should be the other way around. It should be 3EI upon L cube. So it would be 3EI upon ML cube. So this would be the natural frequency. So E of this strip would remain constant. The cross section of this strip, the section modulus would remain constant. The mass, known mass, is constant out over here. And the length is the variable. So this natural frequency would be calibrated with respect to length. So if you see, like, I have changed this length, okay, I can know what is the maximum amplitude of vibration of this mass or this strip, and I would be getting the natural frequency. Now, how do I get it? So, on the top of this particular strip, okay, there is a calibration done. So, there is a calibration done on the top over here. Okay, and whatever frequency is there, okay, you can directly judge out. Okay, so for this particular length, directly this frequency. For this particular length, this frequency. So you don't have to do all the calculations. It is directly given on the strip. What you need to do is attach it to the machine, get the maximum amplitude by adjusting the screw, moving the strip. The maximum amplitude is nothing but the frequency of this particular component, whatever machine component, whatever you are going to look at. So this type of meter is called as Fullerton or single read. Why single read? Because we are using only single strip out over here. So single read. So this is one type of frequency measurement instrument. Let's look at the another frequency measurement instrument. So this is multi-read. So we had seen for single read. Single read had only one strip. Now in multi-read, we have different strips out over here. The name of this one is called as Fram stachometer. So another one, Fram stachometer. Now, you may have seen during your school days or college days, okay, you know about tuning fork. So you have seen this diagram of tuning fork. So tuning fork has a particular frequency. So if you look at one tuning fork, okay, the frequency is set to certain hertz. For another, it's certain hertz. So the tuning fork has a respective frequencies. So just imagine that these particular reeds are nothing but your tuning forks. So what we do is like we put this on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So whatever frequency tuning forks kind of thing are attached on this particular screws. Now, when we look at this one and this entire is your device. What you do is like you put this entire device on the vibrating body. Now this vibrating body is going to vibrate with certain frequency. So as soon as this particular vibrating body transmits its energy to this device, what will happen is like this device will also start vibrating. Now when this device starts vibrating, one of the reed will be vibrating with maximum amplitude. Say for this case, this particular strip is going to vibrate with the maximum amplitude. Now what will happen is like we'll look at this strip and just look at what hertz it has. So this particular strip having this particular hertz is the frequency of vibrating body. So putting multiple different frequency like tuning forks, I said over here, okay, it can be just said as like a strip with a mass, different strips with the mass having unique frequencies for each strip. When put on the vibrating body, the maximum amplitude given by a particular strip with a known frequency, that particular frequency is nothing but the frequency of the vibrating body. So this is about Fram's tachometer. Coming to the third one, this is called a stroboscope. Now stroboscope is different from the previous two what we had seen. In stroboscope, we use light for measurement of the frequency of a particular measuring body. Now if you see, this is a particular instrumentation kind of thing. So this is a control panel and this is a pulsating light. Now what happens is like you may have seen, like, to just to give an analogy of this one with something what you know. Okay, while doing a photography, okay, you know, like you have different ISO. When with the different ISO, you try to capture the images look to be different. Okay, if you want to capture an image of a moving fan and you want to get a still image, what you do is like you decrease the ISO. So at a particular point, what happens is like the ISO of the camera matches with that of the fan and you get a still image. But if you have a different ISO, what happens is the fan doesn't look to be in the steady condition, but it has some rotary motion kind of thing, and the images are not very pretty clear. So what you do is like you image the ISO. What does it do? It adjusts the shutter speed of that camera. So that same concept we are going to use out for this one. So just imagine a light is there. This is the source of light. This is the source of light. So light is coming. So what happens is this light is just like a pulsating kind of thing. So it's on, off, on, off, on, off kind of thing. So what happens is like a particular frequency light is coming out over here, and you have a device. Say you want to measure the, this is a fan kind of thing, and this fan is rotating at a high speed. So what happens is like this is rotating at a high speed, and when you give this particular light, and you have a viewer who is looking at this particular light. So this light can be adjusted. The on-off position or the frequency of this particular light is adjusted by whom? By this control panel. So when you look through this particular, the viewer is looking to this particular fan and looking at the light. What happens is like, you will see there would be certain fluctuations in the light. Then you start increasing the frequency or decreasing the frequency depending upon like what frequency you're operating. So say for our case, like we started from lower and we are increasing the frequency slowly, slowly, slowly. What will happen is like at one particular point, you will see like this light and this fan are steady conditions. Just like what example I've given for the camera or clicking the photo. So this looks to be in a steady condition. Although it is moving, it is rotating. What we do is like we see that it is in the steady condition. So just note at what frequency this pulsating light was given. So that pulsating light is nothing but the frequency of your rotation. So if you know the frequency, you know like it's 2 pi n by 60. So you can find the speed of this particular fan for our example. So to know the frequency, this stroboscope is also used. This stroboscope is generally used for having basically for a low frequency kind of thing, and it is like around 15 hertz. So the lowest frequency which can be measured easily by a stroboscope is around 15 hertz. So basically these are the three devices which can measure the frequency. So we'll stop for the day. If you have any questions or comments, please put in the comment box. Thank you guys. See you again for the next lecture. Thanks.